My son and I conceived the idea this summer that the best way to get real Negro singing in Negro idiom and the music also in Negro idiom was to find the Negro who had had the least contact with the white. And so we loaded up a recording instrument in our Ford car and visited remote lumber camps, great cotton plantations where the Negroes were in proportion to the whites from 25 or 100 to 1, and also certain prison camps in 4 of the southern states. We were right in our theory, I think, because especially in the prison camps, we found the Negroes completely isolated from the whites. They lived in separate dormitories, they ate together, they had no contacts with the whites whatever, except with their guards, and then in purely official relations. So the songs that these men sang for us, many of the men having been in the penitentiary all the way from 10 to 50 years, we think were as largely as possible removed from the influence of white speech and white singing. And we took this recording instrument inside the penitentiaries into remote cabins where we had no, where we couldn't use electricity, where there was no electricity to be used, having with us our own motive power in the form of two large Edison batteries. We had to record, in most cases, under very unfavorable conditions, and our records are not at all perfect, but they did give us what we wanted, the tunes to the songs, and a fairly accurate representation of what the real Negro in the South, removed from white influence, has given us in the way of folk songs.